family time, we're enjoying one of the best activities to do this time of year. Decorate pumpkins, of course. And there are so many ways that you can personalize them to your home and taste without any carving. Here this morning to share some great ideas with us is lifestyle expert Ken Macarone. Thanks for being here, Ken.
Thanks you, Megan. How are you doing?
I'm good. I love that we're not going to be carving it because that's when you get a lot of messy stuff going on.
Exactly. And all of the pumpkins that we're doing today are stuff that you can then repurpose right into Thanksgiving. So it's not you're going to buy this pumpkin this weekend, carving it up, and then, you know, a week later it's going to be, you know, dying and looking gross on your front step. So this is a great way to repurpose things and reutilize them all throughout this autumn season.
You think of everything. All right, so tell us about this first one.
So the first one, this is super easy. It's super simple. It's all it is chalkboard paint. You can buy it at any craft store. You get some chalkboard paint. It's super easy. It's you just want to take the sponge brush that you have over there.
This is so cool.
Yeah, and you just want to, first what you want to do is you want to go up and down.
Okay.
And then once you get that one to, well, get some paint on it. Once you get that one to dry, you're going to go the other way. And when you're finished, it looks just like this.
That.
Then you just use a piece of chalk. You can write anything on it from Happy Halloween to Happy Thanksgiving. Like I said, it transitions right over
this
into the next month.
This is so cool. I'm really excited about this
and the
one.
Kids can draw different faces for the jack-o'-lantern, so there's no carving, and you still get those faces of the jack-o'-lantern.
All right, awesome. Tell us about this next one.
This other one is also really great. It's great for kids because they can use their hands and get messy, which is great around Halloween. So we have Decoupage Mod Podge right here, which is a great product. It's simple, easy. You've used it before, I've
seen. Yes, I have. It is easy.
So it's really easy, and all I got, some newspaper.
Yep.
That's all you need to grab is some newspaper, and all you're going to do is take the decoupage medium. You want to put a little bit on the pumpkin.
Okay.
Then you put your paper over it.
And
And then you put a little bit more of the decoupage medium right over that.
Oh, Ken, thank gosh you're here because I just slob it on, like right on the top.
Oh, no, you want to do a nice clear coat. You want it to come out clear, not too shiny, not too high. So what you do is you just want to make it a nice even coat. It dries easier, it dries more evenly. And then once you get that first coat dry, you just want to use some red paint. And when you use that red paint, you just want to splatter it. And this is what I like to call the whodunit pumpkin.
So
you have the newspaper add a little bit of splatter to give that paint splatter look. And it really gives you that Halloween feel without having to be, again, ghoulish and goblin-y with the jack-o'-lanterns.
And it's a nice conversation starter. Tell us about the third pumpkin.
And the last one is going to be a metallic pumpkin because this is something that you can really just bring right into your Thanksgiving look. All I have right here is just some metallic spray paint. You can do it in silver, gold, bronze, copper, anything. Metallics are super trending on this season.
And
you just
want
to coat your pumpkin with it. And then what I have right here are upholstery tacks. Have you ever seen these before?
No.
So on old furniture, you'll see them around the edges of the chairs.
Okay.
It keeps the fabric in place. It's when there would be like wood arms and then the fabric.
Sure.
And they also use it for tufting. And what's great is they're super easy to push right into the
pumpkin. Of course they are.
You can use push pins too if you want to make it colorful and do all of those polka dots.
Nice.
And when you're done, it looks just like this. It gives you that glamorous look. It gives you that Halloween feel. But again, something like this could easily format right into your Thanksgiving table.
You're translating the fall fashions of hardware and metallics right into this pumpkin. Ken, great ideas. I love it. And thank you so much for the tips too with the Mod Podge. Always great tips from you. If you'd like the instructions on how to design these pumpkins for yourself, we're going to post a link to Ken's website. Just go to WPRI.com and click on the Rhode Show.